Hey everyone, Casey here from Clientric. Today's tutorial, we're going to be diving into Zoho Bookings and how you can set up all of your integrations. So let's log in and I'll see you there. All right, now that we're logged in, we're going to go ahead and set up our integrations. So again, as with every other tutorial so far, you're going to go over to the top right, click the settings icon. Once you click that, you see all of your different integrations down here. And we're going to be talking about some in more details like calendars, so I'm just going to quickly gloss over that one. Now, when it comes to video conferencing for integrations for Zoho Bookings, you have a few different options. You have Zoho Meeting, GoToMeeting, Zoom Meetings, and Google Meet. So Zoho Meeting is directly integrated. It's very easy. We use it all the time. It's very smooth. We do like it as long as you are using Zoho Meetings. GoToConnect Meeting, we haven't actually used this before. I've heard good things about it. We have some clients that use it. But the biggest difference here is that you need to actually set it up using Zoho Flow, which is pretty unfortunate. Sometimes there's some connection issues. It's not a native integration. So that is the biggest downside to GoToMeeting. But if you did want to integrate it, you just click try now. It's going to take you to Zoho Flow and it's going to set up the flow for you however you want. And it'll run you through how you'd actually go about setting that up. We also have Zoho Meetings. This is now a native integration. It wasn't before, and there was a lot of issues with the third-party integration that was set up using Zoho Flow. And that's how I know there's likely going to be some issues with GoToMeeting as well, because there was a ton of issues with Zoom. That's now a native integration, so it's much smoother now, which is very nice. And then last thing we have is Google Meet. Again, this is another Zoho Flow, so it could potentially have some issues within that that you just need to be aware of. But those are your options for video conferencing, and make sure that you are setting this up and using them. They are very helpful when setting up bookings. And in order to actually set them up, you can either click the try now or you can click the enable. So enable here is allowing you to use and access all that stuff. And then it just gives you this notification saying that the meeting is connected. You could also click, let's say, Zoom meetings. Connect to Zoom meetings, you'd have to connect into your Zoom account, and then you're going to have a few different options within here that you can actually utilize and set up the proper connection or booking links or meeting links, anything like that that you'd want. So that is available in there as well. So it's a bit more complexity associated with it. So if you have Zoom and you like it, click that, sign in, and you're going to get some step-by-step guides to make sure that you're setting that up properly. All right, the next integration you can make is with payments. So you have all of these different payment providers that you can set up. And if you remember during our consultations and workspaces tutorials, you had the option to set up a paid consultation. That is where you would set that up. You would say, yes, I'm going to utilize this. And that would utilize any of these that you'd want to configure. And I believe you can even set specific connections to go for specific consultations. But you have to go in there and configure it, and then it will allow you to do all of that. So if you have any specific providers that you use, set that up and go from there. You also have the ability to enable or disable. However, we don't have any payment providers or connections that have been configured, so we are not going to be able to do that in this one. Under calendars, you have the ability to set up Zoho Calendar, Zoho CRM Calendar, Google Calendar, and Office 365/Outlook. Those are the calendars you can enable. We're going to be diving this one into its own video because it is super important. So stay tuned for that tutorial next. And then lastly, we have other integrations available. So we can integrate with Zapier, CRM, Zoho Assist, Zoho Begin, and a bunch of other non-Zoho tools. When it comes to SMS, you have SMS Magic here and Twilio that you can take advantage of. As well as Clockwork SMS. I have never used this. I have used SMS Magic and Twilio, and just configuring that and putting in your information allows you to be able to send out SMS messages with your consultations and the different notifications that go out. Other than that, that's it for this one for now. Please let us know if you have any questions by posting them in the comments below, as well as make sure that you are liking and subscribing to our channel. It allows us to reach more people like yourselves who are looking for more information on Zoho Bookings. So please be sure to like and subscribe. And we look forward to seeing you in the next video. Thanks, bye for now.